Hey, what's going on, everybody? It's Tori, and welcome back to another draft profile. Now, I wanted to get these out a little bit sooner. I kind of feel bad that these are a little bit late, but we're going to try and wrap up 3 draft profiles before the draft tomorrow. So I got 2 planned today and 1 hopefully coming out tomorrow morning. Now, I've been really busy because I've been preparing for the NBA draft live stream that I'm going to be doing tomorrow. That's going to be starting at 4:15, and I really hope you tune in. We're going to try and have the draft stream going on with some face cam, some graphics over the top of it. So hopefully it doesn't get copyright claimed or anything like that. We might have to resort to a plan B, which would be the audio of the stream, and hopefully we'd be fine doing that. I don't know, YouTube's kind of weird with the way they copyright things, but hopefully we're going to be able to have some face cam and have the draft live on stream. I think it'll be a lot of fun, and hopefully you tune in, because it'd be fun to be able to talk with a lot of you guys live as the draft goes along. So with that, let's jump into our 3rd draft profile, and that's for Okpala. Okpala is somebody who did work out for the Portland Trailblazers, and he's somebody who's very intriguing. This is a guy who measured out at 6'9.5", so he's going to be listed as 6'10". He has a 7'2 wingspan as well. That's very good length for the power forward position, and while he probably has to add some strength, I think that's going to be his position long term. And when you look at his skill set, his athletic ability, his ability to defend multiple positions, giving his length and lateral quickness, this dude has a lot of intrigue for me as a switchable modern day stretch four. He's very smooth with the ball, definitely has a decent handle given his length, and he's also not a terrible shooter. Although his shooting could do some work, he's the type of guy who has the mechanics to be a decent shooter in the NBA. He's the type of guy I can see coming into the NBA and immediately improving from the three-point line. If he can be a good three-point shooter, then I definitely think he'll have a long NBA career due to his ability to defend. The NBA is moving to more switchable, lengthy hybrid wings. You're Maurice Harkless and Al-Farouq Aminu types, and Okpala could be one of those types as well. If he's able to add the strength needed to guard centers, you could potentially be looking at a guy who can effectively guard all 5 positions. Those types of guys are very rare, and defenders like that are valuable even if they bring pretty much nothing to the offensive end. But I don't think Okpala will be that guy either. This is a guy who is 5'10 coming into high school, so early on in his life, he got used to handling the ball. He's not one of those typical 6'10 guys of the NBA who got by growing up by using his size. He had to be good with the ball, and you can definitely see that in the way he plays because he can handle the ball. Combine that with his shot, and I really like Okpala as a prospect. He was a very late bloomer. After his freshman season at Stanford, he wasn't even really on any draft radars. But after the start of his second year, he was projected late in the lottery. His stock has fallen a little bit, as now he's projected in the mid-20s, but he's still a guy who presents a lot of upside at that point in the draft. Now, when you look at a lot of the steals in the past decade, late in the first round or early in the second, a lot of them are wings with good size. You're Chris Middleton, Jimmy Butler, Kawhi Leonard at 15. And when you have a guy like Okpala, who has the size and the strength, the type of frame that can put on muscle, he has a decent athletic ability, so he's not going to struggle in that area, and then he has a budding skill set, those are the ingredients for a steal in the mid-20s. In terms of his weaknesses, he does struggle with his three-point shot. He needs to improve his consistency from the three-point line. He's also one of those athletes that doesn't really translate his full athletic ability into basketball movement. The best way I can describe that is think of Pat Connaughton with his vertical leap. He was only really able to make use of it when catching lobs or on the fast break. He wasn't a guy that was able to rise up in traffic and use his athletic ability to his full extent. There's pure athleticism, and then there's basketball athleticism, and Okpala definitely has pure athleticism. He had a 37-inch vertical leap at the draft combine, but I do have questions about how translatable it is, because what I've seen of him, he doesn't play quite as athletic as he tested out at the combine. All in all, Okpala is my second favorite prospect for the Blazers to draft at 25. Number one is Darius Bazley. Number two is definitely Okpala, because I like this guy's upside, and I think he's the type of role player that Portland could have a lot of success in developing. So let me know down in the comment section below what you think about Okpala. And with that, that's a wrap for this draft profile. The next draft profile is going to be for North Carolina forward Cam Johnson, so stay tuned for that. And with that, that's all I got for now. I hope you guys enjoyed the video. This has been Tori. I'll see you guys later. Peace out. Go Blazers.